away for the 2016 Winter Youth Olympic Games. And I've teamed up with the International Olympic Committee to bring you a great series we're calling Celebration Meals. And I love this series because it's all about preparing a delicious dish to help celebrate the gold medal victory of an amazing young Olympian. And today's athlete is Brooke Apshkrum, a fellow Canadian who just won the gold medal in Luge.
Hi.
Hi, Brooke. Hi. Thanks for coming and joining me in the kitchen.
Thank you.
Tell me about your gold medal. Tell me about winning gold at the Youth Olympic Games.
It was amazing. It's like a big shock to my system. You know, you train hard, you work hard, you put all this effort in, and then you get to reap the rewards. It's awesome.
And the moment it happens, what's the first thought?
Oh my gosh. Is this happening? It was, I didn't realize it was happening, you know? It was so surreal.
I noticed that you're not actually wearing your gold medal. How are you not wearing this out? I would be wearing it in the shower. I would never take it off. Where is your gold medal?
It's right in my pocket. I can pull it out if you'd.
Yeah, I want to see it.
Okay.
We all want to see it. I have never won a gold medal in anything. I just want to let you know, so it's going to be a bit of a thrill for me.
There, do you want to hold it?
This is amazing. All right, Brooke, well, to help celebrate your big win, we are going to be preparing something I call my taco-stuffed sweet potatoes.
Ooh.
Have you ever had anything like
no,
that?
No, I haven't.
Are you a sweet potato fan?
Oh, I'm a big sweet potato fan.
So what I love about this dish is that instead of, say, a regular tortilla or a hard taco shell, we're actually using a sweet potato as the vehicle for all sorts of delicious taco flavor.
Sounds great.
All right, so we've got our pan sizzling up. I'm using coconut oil. Do you ever cook with coconut oil?
Totally.
Awesome. I think it's great for sauteing. And we're just going to add some red onion and some red bell pepper to the pan. Let's get our sizzle happening. Very nice, very nice. And we're just gonna cook these for 2 or 3 minutes. We want that onion to start to soften up, the red pepper to start to soften up a little bit. So Brooke, next up, we are going to add our minced garlic and our taco seasoning.
Sounds good.
I love heating up my taco seasoning. I find it toasts up all those flavors really well. There you go. So for our next ingredients, we are going to add our black beans and our corn.
Lovely.
Now, I love this recipe because if you wanted to make it a little meatier, you could do this with some ground beef, or you could do it with some ground poultry.
Ooh.
So both of those would work really well. In this case, I'm using black beans as the protein. Yeah. I do love to keep a dish veg when I can. So we are gonna season this up, of course, with some salt. And of course, some pepper.
Of course.
Salt and pepper. Make the world go round. And it's as simple as this. This is our filling. How easy was that?
Easy.
Right?
Super easy.
All right, so we are gonna take this amazing filling, get it off the heat, and into these lovely sweet potatoes.
Awesome.
What I love about baked sweet potatoes is that you can actually eat the skin. The skin's like full of fiber and deliciousness. So we just gave these a good scrub and then baked them in the oven 40, 45 minutes.
Okay.
And I split them down the center and then fluffed them up with a fork. So, Brooke, now it's just a matter of loading these babies up. You can make it as full as you like, and then we're gonna top it with some cheese and onion.
Sounds perfect.
Go nuts. This is your celebration meal, so you can go as heavy-handed as you want.
I think that's good.
Oh,
do you think any
amazing. It really does.
Yeah.
So next, you can top it with cheese.
Ooh.
I always think everything's better
with more cheese,
but that's just
I think that's a good rule of thumb.
Yeah.
Right. More cheese, more better.
That looks pretty outrageously good. Now the final step, if we can even resist, is just to get these in the oven for just a few minutes until that lovely cheese melts and those potatoes are heated through.
Sounds
perfect. I'm sorry, Brooke. We're gonna put it in the oven and then I swear we'll bring it right back. Oh, and that's what you end up with.
Amazing.
Are we hungry?
Very.
You must be hungry. Yeah. You just won a gold medal. That's hard work. All right, Brooke, the moment of truth. After all this hard work, you definitely have earned yourself a bite. Probably more than a bite. Amazing. So what does it taste like?
Awesome. It tastes like a sweet potato that was like at a fiesta or something. It's awesome. It's so yummy.
Fiesta sweet potato.
Fiesta sweet potato.
That, I think I'm renaming this dish. Fiesta sweet potato. I love it. Brooke, we want to congratulate you once again on your big win.
Thank you
for joining us. Thank you for letting me hold your medal.
Thank you for letting me make the sweet potato.
enjoy your Fiesta sweet potato. Guys, I really hope you'll give this recipe a try at home, and if you do, be sure to tweet us or Instagram us, because we love seeing your creations. Don't forget, the full recipe is in the description box below. And of course, if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the Olympic YouTube channel for lots more tasty recipes like this, and of course, highlights from amazing events from the Lillehammer 2016 Winter Youth Olympics. Highlights from things like Brooke's big win, right?